Hey, what's up guys? I want to do a video here showing you the Smokey Mount Knife Works catalog. Yes, I talked about perhaps making another video like this, and a lot of people showed a lot of support for it. It's fun to hear some different ideas, and when looking at knives just in general, it's kind of like off-the-cuff stuff. It's not like a review where I have one specific knife that I know what I want to talk about, that I've been testing it and using it, and I have things in my mind specific to it. There's nothing planned here at all. It's a catalog. I'm gonna flip through it and, you know, speak my mind. And it's pretty cool because different time, you know, I get really sidetracked too, so different topics pop up all the time. I can tell stories through it or talk about different knives and stuff like that. So I think it's kind of fun. A lot of people said, hey, yeah, make more videos like that. So that's what I'm doing. So today we're looking at the Smokey Mount Knife Works catalog. Definitely a catalog to get if you're a knife guy. There's a lot of them out there. You know, Bud K is usually a lot of cheaper stuff. Atlantic Cutlery, there's really quite a few of them. You can just do a search on Google, type in knife catalog or free catalog knives, stuff like that, and you'll find a bunch of different websites that'll lead you to different places that do have a like requested free catalog. Smokey Mount Knife Works is one of those places, at least in the United States. I don't know if they do, I don't believe they do anything that's overseas, but if you live in the United States, just go to their website, smkw.com, and you can just put in your address and request it for free. What's awesome about these catalogs is that, you know, I don't buy a lot of stuff, but I get exposed to them through this catalog. It's nice to see what's new, see what's the rotation. You don't have to go out there and buy things to understand, hey, this company just came out with something new. It's like what we all do watching YouTube videos. That's how we're exposed to a lot of different products, is through other people telling you about them. So it's really cool. Smokey Mount Knife Works has a good variety of things. They have some tactical knives. I would say, just off the top of my head, a rough estimate is about 60% or so, a little bit more than half of the catalog and company is usually some old school stuff. A lot of slip joints, which is really cool. The beginning of the catalog is usually very heavily focused on W.R. Case & Sons, whatever's new with them. I think that's great. The relationship between the two companies, I'm sure, is very strong. Smokey Mount Knife Works is also a fantastic source for Zippos. People are constantly asking me, where can I buy Zippos online? There's 100,000 places you can buy Zippos online. You can go to Amazon, you can go on eBay. You know, a lot of people, they go to Zippo's website. I wouldn't necessarily go to Zippo's website because it's just like going to Cold Steel's website or Benchmade's website. You're going to pay the most you can pay, you know, buying it direct. Always buy through a dealer. It's always going to be cheaper. Smokey Mount Knife Works always has a good variety of Zippos for a very, very reasonable price. Okay, sometimes it's the lowest price. However, you go on eBay or you go on Amazon, and some of those people, the sellers, you just can't beat their prices. You know, Amazon is a really, really hard company to beat in general for a lot of products. So I always suggest it's your money, it's your hard-earned dollars. Go spend them wisely. All right, do some research and get whatever you're looking for as cheap as you possibly can. But Smokey Mount Knife Works is a great place to stop to see what they have. So anyway, I'm just going to go through this catalog, tell you what I like, what I don't like. I'm going to skip over some stuff that's just uninteresting, and we'll talk. Well, I'll talk. You'll listen. Perhaps. All right, so right on the cover here, pretty exciting because now we're seeing... What are we seeing on the cover? I'm seeing knives, which I love. I'm seeing Zippos, which I love. And they both have guns on them, which I love. So already I'm pretty interested in the cover here. This is part of the W.R. Case & Sons Famous Gun Series line. And this is the first I've seen of this. If they get an AK version, I would certainly be really interested in perhaps getting that. This one's focusing on the M16. Of course, very popular during Vietnam. The Zippo artwork is pretty snazzy looking. It's on a black ice Zippo. $25 is an awesome price for that. See, this is what I'm talking about. When I do a video like this, I get sidetracked because I have lots to say, because I have lots in my mind. Zippos. Zippos are awesome. I think we can all agree on that. They're cool. Whether you use them to smoke or not, they're awesome lighters. They're very, very collectible. Highly collectible. What's really cool about Zippos is that it's a very cheap hobby to get into. Okay, if you're a gun guy, what gets you really excited? Besides maybe like some free ammo from someone. New guns, right? Gun accessories, you get that new holster. What's a holster cost on average? $40-$50? That's two Zippos right there. Of course you want to get a new gun. You love your guns, but you gotta get a new gun. That's just what you do. You're a gun guy. $500-$600 for a new gun? Jesus, that's like a whole Zippo collection, $500-$600. You know? On average, $10 to $30 for Zippo, depending on what kind or where you live or what your accessibility is to Zippos. Of course, I'm referring more to U.S. people. Unfortunately, overseas in different countries, Zippos, as well as knives and guns, if you can even have them, are all incredibly increased in price for because of export costs and the rarity of finding them. That I am truly sorry for. When you are really into these hobbies and everything's just so much more expensive, that stinks, and I feel your pain on that. But yeah, going back to the gun guy, Zippo guy thing, right? Average, let's say on average, you get a couple cool ones, couple cheap ones, you get maybe 6 Zippos for $100. All right, so now you're looking at about 30 Zippos for the cost of a gun, on average. You have a whole collection, or you have one gun. It's just the point I'm trying to make, and it's very cheap. Zippos as a hobby is the cheapest. Knives are kind of in between. You can get $20 knives, of course you can get $500 knives, but then guns are the most expensive hobby of the three. That should be obvious. So yeah, my point here is if you kind of like Zippos, get into it, man. Get into the hobby, it's awesome. You can buy them used, you can buy them new. Doesn't make a difference, I mean, well, depending on what you want. And there's, some people ask me too, like, I like Zippos, but how do I, like, what should I collect? That's totally up to you. I've talked to this before, but if you know, you're new to the channel, if you don't remember that video, because I have a million videos, there's so many different ways or different roads you can go down the Zippo collecting path. You know, some people just collect beer-related Zippos, anything beer-related. I know someone who collects just brass Zippos. I know someone else who is attempting to get a Zippo from every year. They want every single year as far back as they can go. Another person just buying their birth. Let's say you're born 1993. You buy all Zippos that are from 1993, you know, or anything. Some people just buy whatever Zippos they like. You know, it's a good variety. So it's just an awesome hobby. Once I'm done talking about that, because Jesus, I don't know how long this video has been going on. I can't even get past the cover. So anyway, yeah, that's a cool trapper. Really nice. Looks like a smooth white bone. And then you got just some funky, cool artwork. I like that. I like the case coat. Collaboration logo there. That's pretty cool looking. They both got a similar looking logo with that big old C. So, let's see if I can get past the cover here. Ooh, no I can't. Because, let me hide this for a second and tell you. When I saw something on this page, I immediately thought Pete from the Armory Channel. And what a perfect gift for Pete. So let's look at that perfect Pete gift. I'm gonna focus right in on it, right there. Yes, the Colt 1911 Zippo. White artwork on black ice is amazing. Now this is commemorating all of Colt stuff. Of course you got the different models, the Colt Walker, which I didn't even know that was a model, the Walker. I knew about the Peacemaker, and I knew about the Army 1860 model. And of course 1911, but the Walker is new to me. I didn't know what that was, I had to look it up. So interesting gun. But $25 for any of these lighters. And look, if you're looking to be a collector of Zippos, get all four. Now you have the full collection of Colt, you know, commemorative Zippos. Now, I'm not particularly fond of this Colt buoy, but that's pretty bad looking with that M16 on the front. You know, if you have a man room or a garage or something, you get one of those nice, case cutlery, the square cases, the display cases, get that buoy, $180. You got like the coolest looking thing in the room. And every man, a man's man anyway, who walks into that place is gonna go right to that and go, what is that? I want it, that's awesome. Where'd you get it? So, very cool collector's piece. And of course they follow the same theme back into the knives, all the trappers for the different models. So yes, an awesome 1911 trapper. So you got the gun thing going on, you got the knife thing going on, you got the old school thing going on. I mean, come on. 1911 is an old school gun with an old school slip joint. Just really, really cool. So, I mean, you know, Father's Day is coming up. And any of you out there who have fathers who are interested in this kind of stuff, this is where it's at. These are some gifts and a half, if you ask me. Flip it open, and we have more Colt stuff. Just not fond of this. It just doesn't do anything for me, that coloration. I don't know. Yeah, not saying it's ugly or anything, but just not, doesn't float my boat. Some things stand out, and I'm like, oh my god, I have to have that, that's awesome. And other things are just kind of like, eh. I have to say though, I'm really growing, the more I see it, I'm growing more and more fond of this rust lock, which is awesome. By the way, side story, I was with my friend going to an Italian deli in Milford, Pennsylvania, in case you live in the area. And there's a guy there who was behind the counter. I was going there to get some brajol for my friend to make, which is, if you don't know, is amazing. You put some herbage in there and you roll it up like pin. Oh God, it sits in sauce all day. It's delicious. Pete knows what I'm talking about. I'm sure he has brajol all the time. But anyway, I'm probably not even saying that right. I have Italian in me, but I always feel funny when I try to say things like Italian-y, you know, and my friend is so, like, she says it so perfect every time and I can't like match it. I feel ashamed because I am half Italian, but like I say, like mutrel or, you know, the brajol. What's another one? Oh, I can't think of it. Like Parmesan, she doesn't say Parmesan cheese at all. She just says Lucatelli, which is a type of Parmesan cheese, but like nothing else exists. Like the powdered stuff, the sawdust, she calls it, which is hilarious. The sawdust from the store. No, there's no such thing as anything. The only Parmesan cheese, Lucatelli. Oh, by the way, completely unrelated. Again, I mean, I'm like going, it's unrelated, then it's an offshoot of unrelated, so it's nowhere near what you're even supposed to be hearing about right now. But someone mentioned this, I don't know where actually I heard this from. I don't know if it was a comedian or someone told me or someone else sent a video. I don't remember where I picked it up, but I'm going to pass it on to you. And I think it's ironic that when I heard this, I'm like, oh my God, yeah, totally. Like, yeah, what's with that? What's with that, man? But it's the fact that like Parmesan, like you get chicken parm from the store, you know, you go to like your pizza place, you get chicken Parmesan or meatball parm, whatever. They never have Parmesan cheese on it. It's always like let's take a meatball parm hero. It sounds delicious. Really wish I had one right now to bite into, but I don't. What does it consist of? Meatballs, a sauce, bread, mozzarella cheese. That's it. There's no Parmesan on your meatball Parmesan. So it's really meatball mozzarella. So say that next time you're calling your pizza place. Hey, can I get a mozzarella sandwich? And they go, oh, what do you want on that? You're like, same as your Parmesan, only no Parmesan, because you guys don't put that on there. However, I will say, sometimes if you get the meatball parm dinner, now we're getting the dinner, not the sandwich, then they'll throw a little bit of parm on top there. But even then, it's probably not even good parm. It's cheapo stuff. Okay, completely unrelated. Not even close to what I'm supposed to be talking about here. So let's move on. Here's a cool Zippo for the Collector's Club. Obviously, you'd want to be in the Collector's Club if you bought the Zippo. But if you happen to be a member, like I am, it'd be cool to have something like that. Cool tin sign. There's actually some tin signs, I believe, later in the catalog here I want to go over. Because some of them are quite racist. I shouldn't say racist. Well, I'll talk about it when I get to it. It's just one of those things. It's just the era. But now it seems racist. Not that racism is funny. I did chuckle there, if you caught that. I don't think racism's funny, but come on. Sometimes things are laughable. Some things are so sad they're laughable. What do we got here? They're coming close. Ah, the Collector's Club knives. I'm telling you, that rust lock is pretty cool looking. All right, moving on. Here's the slanted bolster case knives. That does nothing for me. Absolutely nothing. Smooth chestnut bone. It's pretty good looking. Very old schoolish. I like the darker colors and stuff like that. Of course, the stags. Very makes me feel like you know, someone's grandpa's knife, which is awesome. Look at this. Receive a free case stainless steel pick/can opener with each case knife purchase. All right. Now this is obviously like a very standard can opener style. They're also calling it a pick. Now, it was an old issue. I don't think there's one here, but you can actually buy a little tool that's specifically made to go into the nail nicks here. So if you have like a hard or stiff knife, a subjoint rather, you don't have to use your fingernail. You just use the tool to get in there. But they're pitching it as like, yeah, use the tip of this because it's specifically meant for that. I mean, I've always seen this, but pretty good marketing there. They happen to notice it works for something else too, so they're going to put it in the title. That's like, I don't know, you can use this to scrape glue off of glass, but you wouldn't say receive a collectible case stainless steel knife pick can opener glass scraper. I don't know, I'm rambling. Moving on, carbon fiber case knives. I talked about this in the other video. Love them. Oh, just really, really cool. A little pricey here though. Definitely pricey. But it's one of those things, if you want a subjoint with carbon fiber, you're not going to find anywhere else. So you can do one of two things. You can buy it and fork over the extra money for it and just weep a little, but then get happy when you get your knife in the mail. Or you can just wait a really long time and hope that they get cheaper. But there's no guarantee in that. So the choice is yours. The back pocket knives, that whole back pocket series, I think is extremely classy. Really cool with that leather thong. Yes, that's a thong lanyard. I know, pretty sexy. These Hawkbill knives, of course, or pruner knives, are really nice. I like them. Of course, in the Stag, like I'm focusing right now, I think is one of the nicest of the bunch here. But pretty cool. Let's see, Trapper Locks. Not so fond of that. Not really my deal. But that's okay. Also pricey, you can see there, about $100 across the board here. And moving on, more case stuff. Case Cheetah. Cheetah design is pretty cool. As you unfold it, the guard pivots. I don't know if I did a video on that. Maybe I have a cheetah I can show. Cheetah. That wasn't right. That's Chia, not Cheetah. What am I thinking? Muskrat's cool. I knew a guy a couple years ago on Knife Forums that only collected muskrats, but he had to have like every one ever made ever, which was pretty cool. Because every time I saw one somewhere, I always sent him a message. I'm like, there's a new one, blah, blah, blah. And I get all excited. John Deere stuff doesn't excite me whatsoever. Never had a John Deere tool or ride-on lawnmower, but I'm sure they're nice. I mean, they have a reputation for a reason. But I don't know, not for me. Yellow Derlin, same deal, not for me. It doesn't excite me at all. The hobo knife, that is exciting. Amberbone, and you can see we're a couple pages in and it's still only case cutlery stuff, which is nice, because I mean, I get to see the new stuff. Okay, moving on to new thing. Oh, by the way, this is something I want to show you. I did that CRKT knife kit thing. And look at these from Case Knives. They have more wooden, you know, build your own knife kits. But look how awesome these are. These are really cool. I mean, much more detailed. A lot more pieces. So it's a little bit more challenging. I mean, look at this. You got your two blades, your two backspacers, your handle scales. They even have your shield that's separate. They come in these cool little tin survival cans. Whenever I see these Altoid tins, I think survival tin because everyone makes videos on survival stuff. That two-tone up there. That is hot looking. That is really cool. So yeah, if you're interested in getting one of those wooden kits, check out the case ones. They're awesome. And look at the prices, $12. Any of these, $11.99. The choice is yours. I think that's nice. All right, moving down to the redneck. The redneck pruner, that's pretty cool. Confederate flag on the shield there. That's actually really nice. Cool looking. The other one says, the South will rise again. Ooh, and I'm a Yankee. I wanna be Southern, but I'm not. That stinks, I haven't even been in the South. But I love Southern culture. I love everything about it. I love Southern hospitality. I just really like the South. I've never even been. I'm gonna have to travel some more. All right, melon testers, talked about those. I'm gonna have to get one for a future video because they're just awesome. They're really unique and no one ever talks about them on YouTube ever. I don't think I've ever seen a video on a melon tester. If you know of a video, not necessarily the case, any melon tester slip joint on YouTube, let me know about it. I'd be shocked if there's a single video, but you be sure to tell me about it. All right, for you knife guys who happen to like Zippos, here's all the different case models. I think they're all cool. My favorite is the first one there. The old school slash, you know, simple logo etched in. American flag one's pretty cool too. And then more elaborate, fancy ones. And then we got some case hats, some sheaths. Yeah, this'll be a long video. All right, Colt stuff. Colt stuff's cheap to me. Nothing really, you know, it's not very exciting. I do like the way that this Woodsman's folder looks. I like this. It's like a chipped, raw, kind of, you know, rustic look. I love that. I actually really, really like that. Buck Knives came out with wasn't the 119, I forget what model it was, but they had a matching 110 with one of their fixed blades, and it had a buffalo inlay in sterling silver. It had this same chipped steel, like it looks like it was fresh out of the blacksmith's, you know, just rustic. It was just awesome. So I like that. That's appealing to me right away. The inlays don't really do anything for me. The cool, funky little squiggly tang, you know, little pigtail in the end is pretty cool. All these knives here, they all look cheap to me. I really have no interest in any of those. And like knives like that, I'd want to pay $5 for, and they're all $25. They may very well be decent knives. They just design-wise, they do nothing for me at all. Here's a Colt Damascus lockback with some, it's like mosaic pins in there. $25. And there's even filework on it. It says on the spine, which just looks like kind of jimping. But yeah, I mean, it's real Damascus if you want a Damascus knife. This is one of those things where it's really cheap and it tries to come off as really, really classy. And it kind of is classy, but not fully. Like, you kind of still know it's cheap if you're a knife guy. But hey, I mean, if you've never had a Damascus knife before, $25, you can't beat that. Here's some pink Colt knives. More than likely, you know, goes to breast cancer, whatever. It's, a lot of times you see pink knives, that's what it's for. The proceeds go to breast cancer. And, well, actually this one doesn't look like it does at all. It just happens to be pink. All right. Actually, on the top there, you got some nice American design there. American flag Colt Customs, they say. And this is the lady leg. This is a pattern I wanted to get into, and I never got one. And because I never had one, I never got into specifically collecting them. They're definitely old-timey, like 1930s, 40s. You know, you saw a lot of those, a lot of cheap knives, a lot of pharmacy knives. You know, you go to the drugstore and you see them back then like that. That style was kind of risque, and it's kind of funky. It's cool. It's a figurative knife. And I think I did a video on one of my old knife collector's books, and they talk about different designs like that. And the figural ones where, you know, the knife, if you took the handle and just completely colored it black, it'd make a silhouette. And that's when you look at different slip joints, they're all different patterns. So, you know, like the lady leg, fold this, sorry. All right, then you have the trapper, the peanut, the canoe. I mean, they all have distinctive looks, right? The double take is another design, or excuse me, a pattern that I've never owned, but kind of always wanted because it was so unique. And I think there's some in the back here I'll get to eventually, 2 hours from now. But the lady leg is one of those ones that's just kind of cool. Some people may think it's completely stupid. I don't know, I think it's just different, which is nice. P.S., if you're looking at this, like on the toilet or something, their fold-out page used to be really annoying to me all the time. Like when I was younger, I used to get this and be like, ah, why are they, because every time I grab it, it'd like unfold. I'm like, what the heck, man? Why is that like that? It's actually an awesome page keeper. All right, so let's say I was done taking my dump, which definitely TMI, I would unfold that, flap it in here so I could keep my spot and flip it back open so I don't forget what I looked at already. Because who wants to look at the same knives twice when you're dropping a load? Am I right or am I right? Maybe I'm wrong. Moving on to page 16. Ah, more cheap looking stuff. Look at that Colt Sebenza knockoff. Couldn't be more obvious. Ugh, that thing's ugly. I don't know, I don't like that. I think it's too gimmicky. It might be functional, but I don't know. I just don't like it. Some throwing knives. Those Colt throwing knives look pretty slick. For $20, three of them. Pretty cool looking. Ah, I dig it. I like that. All right, the boot knife. I'm starting to get into boot knives. And actually, this winter, I think I'm going to get at least one or two different ones. And I'm going to start EDCing a boot knife when I'm actually wearing boots, you know? And you know what's cool about a boot knife is that it's strictly for defense. Absolutely strictly for defense. It's not a utility knife, so pretty much any of them. You can get it the cheapest one you could find. Make sure it's nice and sharp, stick it in your boot, and that's it. It's a done deal. You don't have to worry about blade steel. You don't have to worry about anything. That's awesome. It's not like an EDC knife, even though you will EDC it. It's strictly for defense. So that's a pretty cool one, two-tone. Looks nice. For $20, I would say that's it's worth it, in my opinion. Like I say, what kind of steel is that? Doesn't even matter, as long as it's sharp. It's one of those knives that if you ever need to use it, which you probably never will, you only need to use it once, and that's it. Some old-timey looking fixed blades here. Definitely case-esque, or, you know, case-esque now, but definitely old-timey hunter's knife. Like if your father, grandfather, great-grandfather hunted, this is most likely like the type of fixed blade they'd have in the woods. You know, both these designs were, to me, they're ugly. I'll be honest, I really think they're ugly knives. You know, Big palm swell, very functional. Kind of a narrower blade, functional for its purpose, but I just think they're ugly. I think this knife right here is definitely cool looking. I like it, something a little bit different, sexy blade style. Got some Nesmuk style skinners here. Let's see what these are. Yukon skinners. That's definitely a Nesmuk design. Again, getting into the whole survival type thing, you'll hear about that term Nesmuk and, you know, the Scandinavian knives and all that kind of crap. Those fixed blades are, they're so-so. Take them or leave them. Looks a little fantasy-esque to me. Interesting. What else we got here? Schrade. Wow. That looks just like a Boker Applegate Fairbairn folder. Schrade doesn't make that. What a copy. $20. 20 stinking bucks. Oh, look at this. Schrade. It doesn't look like a Gerber Easy Out. Man. Wow. And that kind of looks like a Gerber Gator. Come on, Schrade. Come up with your own designs. Just kidding. Knife designs are repeated everywhere. Seriously. Anyone who gets caught up with, ooh, that's a copy. Ooh, that's a copy. Probably. But you know what? The copy to the original was most likely, not in all cases, but most likely, a copy to something else. I do have the Schrade Sharp Finger, which I've showed. I have my grandfather's, and I have one that I bought. And that is a cool, funky little knife. Another company who makes it, I believe, is called the Starfighter. I forget, maybe Buck or something. These are all awesome knives to collect and display, okay? This is something I want to talk about. I would not buy and use any of these knives. Nothing. And for the most part, I would, in my mind, say, that's junk. However, it all serves a purpose. Yes, you could still buy it, you could still use it, you could still sharpen it. It's going to be often. Steel's not great, I'm fairly certain of that. But they all serve a purpose. Now, if you're a knife guy, how cool would it be to get like just a cheap $25, $30 display case, okay? Which you could probably get from Smoky Mountain. I'll get to it, maybe. They usually have like a section with sharpeners and display cases. But you get a display case for $30, okay? You fill it with these knives, which are aesthetically pleasing. Now, to someone who's not into knives at all, they look at these and they'd be like, wow, those are really cool. You get the same effect from an $8 knife. You could buy, you know, a handful of these with different designs that you like, you know? Let's look at these. Eagle's Nest, Bobcat Surprise. I mean, these are all like, the Remington, they're kind of playing off of the, the hunting type stuff, old timey type stuff. Looks like the Barlow design. Barlows are cool. I mean, that's a really old frame style. But yeah, for $8 a piece. Oh, here, look, the whole set's $90. All right, what do you get? 2, 4, 6, 8. Ah, crap. Lost my count. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Oh, duh. Big smack of the forehead. Says it right there. 12, master, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Yeah, a dozen of them. I should just quit the video now. A dozen of them. $90 plus, let's say, $30 for a display case. For $120 plus shipping, you can have an awesome, awesome display on your wall in your man cave. How cool. And here's the same thing, just different patterns here. Oh, actually, these are the small Barlows. Oh, even better. These are the big ones. These are 5 inches closed. Holy crap, these are monsters. Wow, all right, well, let's see. Let's cut the money to $80 instead of 90, and we get smaller knives to display. But anyway, that's the purpose I see, you know. It could be a really cool idea to get something cheaper and just make a really beautiful display. And, you know, something like this, if you happen to have, like, a big, big old family, you know, maybe it comes to be Christmas time, and you're someone's grandpa, or who knows, maybe you're just someone's dad. And like it's a big family Christmas thing together, and it's a bunch of like, you know, not real young kids, but maybe a bunch of 9-year-old boys or something at the party, and you go, oh, it's Christmas, and you can each pick a knife or whatever. You can have like a fun time with it. And it's gonna be the world to them. It costs you $8. No big deal. But they'll probably save that knife and, you know, hang on to it for a very long time, if not forever. Alright, moving on. I know. I ramble too much. The Buck Haley Heath Ergo Hunter. Here, Gus is totally snoring in the background. Wow. He's tired. I took him for a walk before. Bear with him. Fixed blades don't do anything for me, but these folders are actually pretty intriguing looking. Interesting colors with the purple and the green. I kind of like just the plain gray one, but look at the blade shape here. Looks like we have that kind of roughed up surface on the top there for like a pinch grip if you're choking up on it. We saw that in Buck's, one of their Strider collaborations from back in the day, and it was really popular. I think it was the Terrani, I don't know, police model or something, but they had that same kind of rough texture deal on the steel. It was a steel deal. These are actually really good looking knives. They got a finger choil right up in the blade. Looks like you can really choke up on it. Fatter handles. 420 HC on the Select. And the Avid is a 12C 27 MOD. And of course the Pro. Oh, so it's gonna be like the Vantage type deal here where, you know, same knife, three different grades of it. So you're getting a bump in steel, but you're also getting a bump in price, all right? So for 420 high carbon, which is definitely decent, you know, $55 here, jumping all the way up to the S30V, 125. So you're really being, you know, more than double the price. You have to really ask yourself, is it worth it? In some cases it will be. The Martini knives, someone actually recently offered me a trade for Martini. Kind of just a different version of the, had a brain fart. A stinky one, it is. The Frost Mora Sweden knives. That's it. Different, basically the same thing from a different company. You can see the prices reflect pretty much the same as well. So, definitely cool knives though. Never had one. I've seen them in person. But, yeah. I mean, if you happen to be a huge fan of the Mora knives, then I would certainly check one of those out. All right. Here's some sexy, cheaper throwing knives. Look at this set of three. Really cool looking. You can have tons of fun. Really impress your friends. $28. It's from Blackjack Knives. Blackjack Knives makes them, they have a fixed blade I really like, and I had one for about 2.5 weeks, and I traded it. I never did a review on it, but it was definitely decent for the money. So looking at Blackjack Knives in general, do some research if you've never heard of the company before. They have a little single throwing knife here that really just, it looks cheap to me. I mean, it's $10. It is kind of cheap, but I'd rather get a set of three for $10. And we have some Victorinox stuff here. Good lord. This must be having a bad dream. All right, we have the Swiss Champ XAVT. Only $360. I hope that comes with a really special pair of shorts with like a 7.5-inch pocket to hold that thing. Look at that beast. 22 functions? Well, 22 tools. 77 functions. Boy, oh boy. I like these when they're really fat like that and they're loaded up with stuff. It's certainly a novelty. You know, I something like that I'd collect. I'd display. I wouldn't necessarily carry it and use it. I would be, you know, really shocked to find if anyone actually who owns this uses it. It's still a cool collectible. Nothing really special there. Some cold steel stuff. I like a lot of cold steel things, but I'm not going to go into great detail here. See the Bushman up top. Little tomahawk. I really like some cold steel folders and a couple fixed blades. Most of their other stuff I like, but not enough to like, you know, to get or buy or anything like that. It just they happens to cross my path. I'll check it out. Benchmark stuff. Benchmark. You'll see. Like, look at this. Look at the logo. If you looked at this really quick, what would you think this knife is on the bottom? Benchmade, right? I mean, the logo looks really, really close. Of course, we have the same Applegate Fairbairn style-esque design there. But that looks just really similar to me. I don't know. Maybe I'm losing it. I believe Benchmark, I think who designs their stuff is Collins. I can't think of his name now. Not Phil Collins. I don't care anymore. No more. All right, a lot of the young viewers have no idea what I'm talking about. But you older guys, yeah? You know what I'm talking about? No mo. I don't care no mo. I don't know. Bucky Collins? I can't remember his name now, because now Phil Collins is stuck in my head. Jesus. I don't know, can't think of his name, but I think he designed a lot of stuff. Yeah, nothing on this page does anything for me. Nothing. This is pretty funny. Look at this. Here's definitely a racist thing. We have some stilettos here. Okay. And they're I want to meet the advertising guy here. I mean, I get it. It's funny. But, like, I don't know. Wise guy, stiletto lockbacks. Now, wise guy. Here's the name. We have Big Joey, Tommy Two Sticks, and Little Paulie. Now, I think you'd have to be completely from a different country to not understand that this is a joke on the Italian mafia, which is somehow racist. That, I mean, I see it kind of racist. Like, you have to be Italian to like this type of knife, and it's obviously advertised as an Italian. I mean, yeah, okay, it's an Italian stiletto. Comes from Italy. Am I weird to think it's still somewhat, just somewhat racist? You know, I don't say like, oh, you have a Mora, you Swede, you know, or I don't know, you have a, an Okapi, you African. I mean, it just, I don't know. I mean, obviously they're playing on it. It's a fun, whimsical thing, but, you know, I don't know. Do you know? Because I guess I don't know. By the way, stilettos are absolutely awesome, but they got to be automatic. You know, the cheapo manual stilettos, it's just saying, hey, I like stilettos, I think I'm cool, but I can't find a real automatic one, or I can't have one. They do serve a purpose. If you want to carry that, you know, it's still definitely cool. Yeah, I like it. I don't know why I laughed. I'm strange. I admit that. I am strange. But I thought that was funny advertising thing to totally sell this as like, yeah, if you think you're a mafia guy, you got to get one of these because that's funny. By the way, not funny at all, okay? Because it's because, not because of the mafia, but because of like the 50s era gangs using these type of knives that they originally set in all these stupid automatic knife laws, which were donkeyless. Yes. All right, some kitchen stuff. And Gus having an extra big snore right there. Eh, not interested. All ceramic, Sandoku style knives. That's, nah, don't need to talk about it. Wenger, this is awesome. And I really see this catching on. I foresee a lot of you guys seeing this and going, yes, I want one. And it's completely blacked out Swiss Army knife. Why have Victorinox not done this already? Maybe they have. Maybe I missed the you know, I didn't get that email. But these are definitely cool. And I totally see a lot of you guys wanting this for EDC. It's a blackout Evo Grip 10 and on top the Evo Grip 63. And it's that simple. It's existing models they already had, but they blacked them out. I think it's awesome. So if you got one of these things, make a video on it. I'd love to see it. All right, more old-timey stuff here. You know, flashbacks, Heroes on the Silver Screen. Cheapo $5 knives, again, you know, if you remember these shows or grew up with these shows, buy the $5 knives, you know, they're cheapo knives, but they're great display pieces, really cool. Red Ryder, Dale Evans, Little Beaver, Roy Rogers, Zorro, all that kind of stuff. And moving on, what else do we have? Don't mind me, just looking at stuff. Yeah, shotgun shell knife. Pretty cool if you're a gun guy. If you got a shotgun rig or something. Well, I was gonna say you could put that in there so you always have a knife, but you may think it's a shotgun shell. And you may try to put it in your gun. That wouldn't be good. Boop a doop boop boo. It's just so random. Just a bug magnifier. What the heck? No, no, that just seems a pretty random spot to put that. Okay, oh God, there's so much stuff to go through. I'm gonna speed up the process a little bit here. Definitely a very, very cool little boot knife. I love that design. I think that is wicked looking. For $9, I mean, they're showing it as a neck knife here. In fact, I might eventually get that when I can. I think I'll buy a couple of those because those look awesome to stick in your boot or even a high sneaker. Really, really cool. I wanna talk about this. It's actually pretty decent looking. United Cutlery, it's really just nothing to write home about, but that is a cool looking karambit. And the same idea as the boot knife. It's not a knife you're gonna use for EDC. This one happens to be $37. It's an AUS 8. It's got some, looks like some resin-ish type handle scale, so it looks like it could be comfortable. I'm a huge fan of the karambit style knives. I really, really like them. As far as a defensive blade, I think it's probably one of the most effective if you know how to use it. The flip side of that is that it's scary looking. And if you do have to defend yourself and you're going to have to go to court and explain why you hurt that bad person and, you know, your peers, which are usually sheeple, are going to look at you and go, why are you carrying that bad knife? Yes, you're guilty. So having something like this and defending yourself something like this as compared to, here, look, you can have this knife and you're just minding your business and someone totally comes out of nowhere, starts punching you in the head, they're trying to kill you for no reason, they're whacked out. You can cut them with this and you go to court and you have a much different effect of people looking at you and judging you because you use this knife, as opposed to if you cut the same person in the same situation with this knife. This knife, you're totally an innocent guy. This knife, you were looking for trouble. And it seems ridiculous, but that's so true. And you gotta be aware of stuff like that. Sometimes you'll carry knives and be like, yeah, you know, it's legal, it's fine. Really think about it. If you have to use that knife to defend yourself, how's that gonna look to you? How's that gonna look, not to you, but to your peers who are not knife people? They don't get that you like knives. They don't care about knives, they don't like knives. In fact, they don't even wanna be at jury duty. They're already pissed off. So they don't want to come in and see this and go, yeah, no, that guy, he wasn't defending himself. He's looking for trouble. He must be one of them robbers, you know, one of them gangsters. Look at that knife. All right, moving on to the fad of paracord. It's a fad. Admit it. Paracord bracelets are a huge fad, but I love it. Who cares? Who cares if it's a fad? You know, 10 years from now, we might be looking back at this and going, yeah, I remember when I wore a paracord bracelet. What a loser I was. You know, just like looking back and wearing the Swatch. However, on the flip side, the Swatch came back and all of a sudden the Swatch is cool again, right? So I think this is going to go full circle. There'll be a time where people are laughing at you for your paracord bracelet, but you know what? Hang on to it, because there'll be a time after that where they like it again. And this is what's really cool, because I think paracord bracelets, they completely, I would guarantee that they got their fame from YouTube. They have to, right? Well, perhaps the forums too. But like the people who run this company, the people who sell these products, they know, they're watching YouTube videos, they're reading forum threads, okay? They're people, they want to see what you want to buy. This is popular, so now they're selling it. You know, you even got Monkey Fist down here. Monkey Fist, the first guy who made a Monkey Fist and put it in the tactical community, it was probably laughed at. But now it's in a very common, popular catalog. All right, Zippos. I can go on for a while with these. I'm not going to. I will just look at this page and tell you what I like, what I don't like. Here's another awesome gift for Pete. Colt 1911 Zippo. Really, really cool artwork on there. Although I have to say, I wish they continued the flag up into like it was one, not like two images like it is here, because it takes away from the bottom one a little bit, but I still think it's cool. If you're into Tarzan, these are some really cool ones, but I don't, not at all. Just don't care about Tarzan. Hate to say. Some Harley ones. Mr. 45 Bullet. Want to get him a birthday gift. That's it right there, $20. Be happier than pig and crap. Some really nice wildlife ones. Oh, here, let me give you a close-up. Show you which, let's see, which one do I like the most? I have a thing for owls. My grandfather did. I think that's pretty cool. And I love the engraving on the sides of the Zippo. It's really nice. It's a nice book. And of course the eagles, nice looking too. I don't know, I like all wildlife, but the owl, I don't know, stands out a little bit to me as being different. Okay, more Zippos. Some armor Zippos. Oh, here's some Zippo cases. Hey Jeff, where'd you get that Zippo case? I got it from Smokey Mountain Knife Works. The one in my background that like, well, actually it's not my background anymore, but I've showed it before. Smokey Mountain Knife Works. They still sell it. $33. Go get one before they sell out. It's the exact same case that I have on my wall that I show my Zippo stuff in. Here's a Zippo sock thing. This is pretty cool. I mean, for $3, come on. You gotta get a couple of these. You can store your Zippos that you use. Just an easier way to do it. Now, this is the Zippo case. Like it has the inserts for the Zippos. You can see they're square. But they sell the exact same collector's case, like the cases I have in the background, my video, my webcam videos to the right. Got it from Smokey Mountain Knife Works. Same thing, it's like $30. It just doesn't have that insert, it has a foam insert instead. Totally have to do it. How can you not? If you got more than 5 knives, don't keep them in your drawer. Display them. Put them in your room. Put them in the den, wherever. All right, we're on to the tin signs. I'll go right to the ones that I think are racist, which are just funny racist. It's not like mean racist, it's just funny. I mean, come on. But you know what, it's racist, but at the time, like it was accepted. So it was still racist back then. It's just, come on, Jim Ed's Blackberry Punch. All this stuff, it's old timey. Uncle Remus syrup. Come on now. Two cool ones on here. We don't call 911. We use we use Colt. It's not a 1911, it's the other model. They should put a 1911 on there. That's actually a bumper sticker I saw. I don't call 911, I call 1911. Another gun one. We don't call 1911, or we don't call 911. Don't tread on me. Just some stuff for your bar room, whatever you do. Welcome to the Nut House. All right. Not going to go over a lot of this because I'm just... The video's really long. I really could just talk and talk and talk. All right, I'll continue to talk a little bit. Very, very cool shield. This little axe for a slip joint. So, my favorite slip joint on this page, probably just the Trapper. But check that out. That Trapper with the hatchet shield. Ugh, been working outside all day. I got dirty thumbnail. It bothers me. I don't like having dirty fingernails when I make videos. It is what it is. Yeah, that's a cool shield. And I happen to really like white. I like white on knives. All right, now let's talk about the double takes. Remember I was telling you about double takes? And it's a cool concept. And they're not new or anything, but the double take is basically a pattern as if you unfolded it, so both handles are showing. And here's an example of one. Actually, there's a couple on this page. These are Rough Riders, by the way. Here's a double take Trapper. So there's your Trapper, right? But it's as if you unfolded it, but that's one knife. Okay, so you get four blades in it, and it's that like dog bone shape. And on the bottom, we have double take Canoe. They're kind of funky, they're interesting. Double take Muskrat, and you literally get twice, it's like two of the same knife, but it's built into one knife. So definitely interesting conversation piece, and if you're a knife guy who knows about this kind of stuff, you certainly appreciate it, because you do not see these often, the double takes. So they're unique, and for $12, it's a cool little knife to have. Just some more random stuff. The Deer Slayer knives, I mean, they're big, bad slip joints. They're pretty cool. I personally don't own one right now, but I have owned them in the past. Some more just random stuff. More slip joint. Oh, here's another double take up top. Another muskrat and different Hana material. Good Lord, Gus. Gus, you alright? He's just really tired to sleep. Not really talk about that. It's not frost. Ugh. Yeah. I'm sorry about that. And now we're into the frost. Okay, 50 knives for $2 type stuff. This one specifically is $20 for a dozen of their pieces of crap that aren't worth buying. This is kind of cool. Little desktop mini katana. That's nice for your office at work, if you're allowed to have that. If you work at McDonald's, don't bring that to work. Nothing else on this page I want to talk about. Here's some just really just screams flea market. I have to say, these knives right here, they're pretty cool looking. But I would never want to get caught with one, because it just seems too cheap to me. Do you ever see that? Do you ever see like a really cheap knife and you're like, wow, that looks super cheap, but you're kind of like the kid news going like, ah, it's pretty cool. That's what those tell me. Like if someone whipped that out of their pocket, I'd probably like giggle to myself. I wouldn't laugh in their face and point at them and go, ah ha ha, but I'd giggle to myself in my mind and think, oh geez. Yeah, that's what that's all about, just cheap stuff. Marbles actually make some pretty good hatchets. Okay, so if you're into hatchets and you try some cold steel and you tried some, Gerber, you get at Walmart or whatever. If you're a hatchet guy, or a machete guy, Marbles company makes both pretty good, both hatchets and machetes. So they're definitely worth checking out. And Mike, looking for me marbles? I found them. They're on page 61. Get yourself a catalog. And by the way, more marble stuff, the fixed blades. Never owned any of their knives, but I did have one of their machetes, and I did use one of their hatchets. SOG, SAG always has some good stuff. Obviously, they're staples, as I mentioned before in the review I did recently. Their Flash series is fantastic. The fixed blades are pretty cool. I'm still testing the SAG Creed, which I will do a review on soon. Showed plenty of that in videos. Smith & Wesson stuff, just doesn't do anything for me. If you want to get like a decent tactical pen, the Smith & Wesson pens are fine for 20 bucks. Well, here are the 27, but you get a couple models for 20, 19.99, stuff like that. They're a decent pen to carry around. Now, here's the only exception. Here's a Smith & Wesson knife I do want to try. And it's this honeycomb frame, frame lock folder. When I first saw it, it kind of reminded me of a Strider, like briefly, and then I'm like, nah, not really. But the honeycomb pattern, like G10, really, it piques my interest. I really want to see what that feels like. I would get this specific knife right here. It's $22. Might try to get one in the future for review, because that seems interesting. And it's cheap. People are always asking for cheaper stuff. Of course, the K-bars, BKTs are fantastic knives. People did plenty of reviews on those. The companion on the right, which the smaller version, not so much. They have a new combat kukri, but it is pricey, $90. I don't know. I still think that would be a pretty functional knife. And that's pretty much it. Back cover here, we got just some cheapo cheaperson. I don't know. Uninteresting. So that's it. That's my my thoughts on Smoky Mountain Knife Works current issue. And that's it. And there's a website, SMKW, in case you saw something here you want to look at more or you want to buy those cases. The coolest thing I think that you get from this video is the display cases, because that's, I really get that question a lot. And if, like I said, if you got more than five or six knives just sitting in a drawer, why not display them? You know, especially if you pay good money for them. So get a display case for 30 bucks, and shipping I think is still like $8 or $9 or something. Don't quote me, I don't remember what it is. But that's it, they're really, really cool. Show off your stuff. You don't have to use them just for knives. You can show them your Zippos, show off your gun. Get a $30 case, cut out a little bit of the foam, and display one of your guns you're not using. So anyway, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and the ramble and just the off-the-cuff talking. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you soon. Take care.